हाय, गुड मॉर्निंग रत्नेश।
गुड मॉर्निंग अनु, वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग। ओके, सो होपफुली यू गॉट द डॉक्यूमेंट।
या आई गॉट द डॉक्यूमेंट, पीपीटी एंड द रिकॉर्डिंग एज़ वेल।
ऑल राइट, सो हैव यू गॉन थ्रू द पीपीटी?
या आई गॉन थ्रू द पीपीटी।
ओके, सो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग आवर डीप डाइव ऑन द demo side, actually, what is your understanding on Active Directory?
Active Directory, like, it is a directory where which create a users group or use, and which provides you the authentication.
Mm-hmm.
And like in on premises, we use Carbos over there.
Kerberos, right?
And so, for domain joining, we make an OUs, computer OUs, hardware OUs.
Mm-hmm. Right. So means the identity solution, like I as Active Directory, is mandatory, right?
Yeah.
So you have to provide some identity solution like Active Directory. Else, how user will be logging? You know, how you are going to apply the security policy. Okay. Yeah. So now coming to Azure Active Directory. So what is Azure Active Directory?
Azure Active Directory is the same, but it will be created on the cloud platform.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So that it user can get the authentication from there to get it login and to get the system joined into the Azure cloud.
Mm-hmm.
So it can be synced and work properly.
Okay. Have you heard about this modern authentications like OAuth, OpenConnect, OIDC, SAML authentication? You heard about all those things?
Not about the SAML authentication. And
okay, you know Kerberos.
Yeah.
And you know NTLM authentication, Kerberos, yeah. NTLM, right? So yeah. Actually, the challenge is with those authentication authorization, the Kerberos and with LDAP, you know, Kerberos is not secure, actually.
Okay.
It's very prone to be hacked. So a reason behind, because it's using secret, like the one secret key, actually. So you must heard about public key, private key concept, cryptography.
Yeah.
Have you done BTech or you normal graduate?
I have done the BCom, but I have done diploma courses in IT, like MCSA.
Okay. Right. So crypto, you heard about cryptography?
Yeah, I have heard about the cryptography.
How will you define the cryptography, sir? Encryption, decryption, right?
Yeah.
So in encryption and decryption, we use generally public key and private key. Okay. So in that way, you are going to secure your data. You're going to secure your authentication, your authorization, your audit. Right. So the important, so the problem with this Kerberos only uses one key. Single key, no public and private key. Means if it got compromised, you gone, sir.
Okay.
So offline you can read about the cryptography things. There are two asymmetric, all those things that is going to benefit you longer run. But yes, that's not required for now. But in Azure Active Directory, it's supporting all the modern authentications like OAuth, OIDC, SAML authentication, but this our on-premise was not supporting earlier, right? But Azure Active Directory makes this supporting like anything, okay? Apart from that, there are many other third-party identity provider like Okta solution, okay? AWS has its own directory services, same like Google. Google has its own directory, okay? Okay. Like you are using Gmail, you know, they have organization level their directory service as well. So Gmail, we are using a personal one. So as my company is Google Cloud Support and Global Online Training, we are using Gmail, professional Gmail, paid Gmail actually. Okay. So Gmail is also providing mail solution like O365. So many identity solutions are available. We have to focus on how we can integrate with the Azure cloud, right? Mostly our focus will be on Azure Active Directory. So you defined very well, actually, users and groups, right?
Yeah.
How to create users and groups. Same thing will be in Azure Active Directory, but a little different actually here. Things are very different. It's not like you going to access your domain controllers, you know, global catalog server. All those things will be not here. Yeah, that's a major difference. So mostly, Azure AD concept we are going to discuss, and the difference also, how it is different from there, and how you can join your, what is workgroup and what is domain?
So workgroup, like we join a machine, in domain we join the machine, like our organization, and workgroup, like we create provide the host name over there, and then we do that.
Right. So the difference, like how it is different actually?
So
let me help you. Remember your cyber cafe days. Okay. So you were sitting in any cyber cafe, even be in Narehi, Indranagar, anywhere in Lucknow. So you have seen there were multiple terminals, right? But no terminal is talking to each other. All terminals are separate, isolated kind of. So that is the workgroup concept. Means one computer is not communicating with another computer, and all the computer not in sync. So you must have seen in cyber cafes in older days, Windows 10 was not there, if I remember correctly. And even Windows 7 might be there. Windows 7 or Windows XP. You must have seen XP. So with XP also, there are different flavors of operating system. So you must be seeing different flavors of operating system. The cyber cafe means your computers are not in sync and they are not talking to each other. But come to your SCL Lucknow office. So when you are going to office, luckily, still we are working from home. So you will see like all the computers within your OMC, within your business area is talking to each other, right? You can you can ping, you can NS lookup, all those things. Getting my point? So actually, domain is kind of, logical entity, you can say, which is making sure that all your resources are talking to each other. There is a bell established communication. And in workgroup is not, workgroup is for to work in isolation.
Got it.
Same kind of thing is in Azure AD join also, but things are different. What is this Azure Active Directory editions?
I think there are different kind of Azure Active Directories are there.
Take this as a licenses.
Okay.
So how many licenses are available in Azure Active Directory? There are two, P1 and P2, the premium one and premium two. Okay. So P1, like you are not going to get security bundle. Okay. PIM, privileged identity management, will be not part of your product line. In P2, you are going to get PIM, all the security features enabled for Azure Active Directory. You will see large enterprises like SCL, TCS, everyone is using P2 license always. Premium, two. Okay. What is second last? What is this?
SSPR. Cell Service Password Reset, SSPR. So it is used to for the cell service of the employees or end users to reset their password, to unlock their accounts.
How it is related with the GSD or your SCL services?
Yeah, so we are using the self-service password. So it is related, like we required to do the automation, and once it is done, then we put on this portal over there, so that it will be used by the end user by themselves to reduce their count, to reduce the end user issues, so that they can resolve those things by themselves only.
Yes. So actually, earlier it was kind of headache.
Yeah.
For employee and for the IT services also. So we used to get call from the, you know, users or employees, please, can you please my reset password? Getting my point? So yeah, those kind of bullshit is not no more, right? So that of feature you are going to get through Azure Active Directory. And we are using since last many years. Okay. So this is kind of, you know, you can see a mix of your Azure Active Directory, and it is also showing your on-premise thing. Okay, so let's try to understand from the left, shift left actually. Okay, so this is your on-premise. On-premise means your on-premise data center, or here we are talking about on-premise identity, Active Directory, local one, right? So how it was happening, you have Kerberos and TLM. All authentication was, so there are AAA, authentication, authorization, and audit, right?
Yeah, so
all AAA was happening through Kerberos and LTM. NTLM is kind of gone case. Nobody is using, okay? This was NTLM, if I remember, this was for Windows 2000 or 2003, I think. Even not 2003 also. Nobody is using NTLM. Kerberos is still in use. But the challenge is, it's not secure, as I already highlighted to you, right? Now, coming to common thing, you know, in AAD and your AD actually. So users, groups, authentication, authorization, everything is common. But what additional things we are getting, you are getting, or we are getting, right? The SAML, remember? I think all those things name I already taken. OAuth. OpenID, OIDC also we call it, and WS Federation. So all these things are modern authentications. And why do we need modern authentication, Anu?
So that our data should be secure and it should not be compromised. And like company can grow their, like company can able to use their data from anywhere, from any locations.
Right. So just take example. They are using Facebook and we are using Instagram. Right? Great example. Right. So whenever you already logged in to the Facebook, whenever you're going to Insta, you need not to log in again and again. Okay? It automatically it is taking single sign-on, right?
SSO. Yeah, single sign-on.
Yes. So how the Instagram and Facebook are communicating? Through API. What is API? Application Programming Interface.
Interface, yeah.
Right. So actually, era of API. So applications are communicating through API connector or API gateway. So where Kerberos is not going to secure all those nonsense things, you need modern authentication which supports those API calling. And those calling will be also secure. It should not be compromised. That's why we need modern authentication, right? And through it, through this Azure Active Directory, you can connect with your Azure Azure Cloud actually, okay? And in Azure Cloud is providing a lot of services, unlimited services. And today we are discussing, you know, first session. Tomorrow we will see, if you log in your Azure Cloud, in your subscription, you will see two or three more services got added.
Okay.
So that kind of, you know, the variety or like versatile character you are going to see for any cloud, not only Azure, for all the clouds. So you have to keep yourself up to date. You know, you have to make yourself ready to, you know, you have to make yourself under sale. You are ready for sale and you are ready with all the equipments all your cloud knowledge, and you can crack the interviews also. Because within your own company, you're working with the X company, I'm working with Y company, right? Within mm-hmm. the same company, you are not going to get monetary benefits.
Yeah.
Same kind of respect, same kind of, your favorite domain, actually. Getting my point?
Yeah, I'm getting it.
So you have to think, and you have to move on for next company, actually. Right. So this is the structure, and the benefit of the cloud-based Azure Active Directory is like you can deploy easily, you can manage it easily, and you can use anywhere, and it supports all the modern authentication. That's the beauty of Azure Active Directory. Okay. What is hybrid identity, Anu?
So hybrid, like, it will be in the both Azure as well as in the both the form it can be used.
Mm-hmm. No, can you explain me again?
Like in on-prem server as well as on cloud server, both it can be used. Hello. Hello.
Yeah, I'm back. I'm sorry. Okay. Sorry. So if it the identity will be the mix, right? If mm-hmm. you are using Active Directory plus Azure Active Directory, that will be known as your hybrid kind of, okay? So just go one by one, these definition, these terms, because you should be aware about those. Go one by one, please.
Okay. Identity and object that can be authenticated. Account
example,
and...
Tell me example. We have to understand this thing. What is identity?
So identity, like my user ID, it is an identity. So it should be authenticated.
So identity means what?
The unique name, you can say.
Mm-hmm. Unique name, right. So within the Azure Active Directory, there should be some unique name, right? Yeah. That can be authenticated, any object, okay?
Yeah.
It could be user, a unique user. It could be unique computer name also, any kind of identity. Okay, next.
Next, account and identity that has data associated with.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, there should be an identity which have a data, like account, it is saying.
I will tell you example, then you will understand. Service account?
Yeah.
So, that's a great example, right?
Hmm.
Okay. So, you understand identity, account by term. Next.
Azure AD account, an identity created through Azure AD or another Microsoft cloud services.
Simple, right?
Yeah.
It's very simple. Go ahead.
And then Azure AD tenant/directory.
Mm-hmm.
Dedicated and trusted instance of Azure AD tenant is automatically created when your organization sign up for a Microsoft cloud service subscription. Additional instance of Azure AD can be created. Azure AD is the underlying product providing the identity services. The term tenant means a single instance of Azure AD representing a single organization. The terms
So actually, why do we need tenant in Azure Active Directory? So remember, just recall your on-premise Active Directory. Okay, so how we are managing there? What are servers required there? Domain controllers?
DNS required.
DNS required, DHCP required, domain controller required, right?
Yeah.
DC and global catalog server required, right? All those,
yeah.
All those role servers required, actually. There are FISMO role, you know, five FISMO roles.
Hmm.
So actually, in cloud services, you are not pawning your domain controllers. In the backend domain controllers, global catalog server, everything is there, sir. But Microsoft, because it's the cloud services, right? You have to sell your service as a service.
Hmm.
As a service, SaaS, remember? So to make it SaaS, the term they're using, tenant or directory services. So tenant means nothing. Tenant means organization, means SCL, Wipro, okay. TCS. So TCS has many tenants. IBM has many tenants, means many directory services.
Okay.
So there will be one default tenant, and later on you can also create multiple different and new tenants also. So tenant means nothing. Tenant is kind of, you know, you can understand in the backend on the tenants, all your domain controllers, your global catalog server is lying in the backend. Okay.
Okay.
So each tenant will be different.
Okay.
Whatever load you are, you know, that kind of directory services, your domain will be also changing. Getting my point? Because with the tenant, your Azure domain is also associated. For one directory, there will be different domain. But for different directory, there will be tenant, different domain. Right? Same like, think about Active Directory. There was forest. Okay? In the forest, multiple domain.
Trees
are there. But forest concept is not here in Azure Active Directory.
Mm-hmm.
Here is directly domain concept. Clear?
Yeah.
And the last. What is last?
Azure subscription used to pay for Azure cloud services. Means, how much you use, only that amount you have to pay for.
Yeah. So Azure subscription is like, whenever you are registering yourself, have you registered as a free tier?
Yeah, I have registered.
And how many deduction happened? 1 or 2 rupees?
2 rupees.
You will be getting refunded it very soon. Okay. So, and you have to smartly use this. Okay. $200 for, I think, mostly 1 month, mostly you have to use it, right? Within 1 month.
Okay.
So Azure subscription is nothing. When you have created your free tier account, so Azure subscription will be associated with your account, in which all your billing data, you know, how much you are using, it will show you what is your uses, what is your balance amount, and what are the services you are using within the under your subscription. So subscription is kind of top level of organization things. But like you're using free tier, but companies like, you know, ABC companies, they might be using multiple subscription because they have a lot of services, a lot of, you know, projects, so they might be using multiple subscription for their clients. Okay.
Yeah.
Any question?
I have one question. Like, if like I'm migrating the things from on-prem to cloud, so we need to open the Azure ports over there to get the thing synced on our domain. And so is there any specific port for that, or what, any range?
So that's like later on question, actually. We'll discuss all those things. Okay. So park it, park your question, because we are still, you know, covering our identity and solution. Okay. So we'll cover that, how we can, you know, I think your concern is domain joining or migration?
Migration. In migration, like, they required that the cloud port should be open over there. So, but what is happening that it's getting changed every time?
I know. And there is a lot of add-on also in the ports, you know, new ports should be there and all those things. Yeah, we'll touch upon. So it's an early question. Just park it. You will get answer automatically. No need not to, you know, park for longer time. Okay.
Yep.
Okay, so what is difference between Active Directory and Azure Active Directory, AAD?
Azure Active Directory, like it is a like cloud based, we are doing Azure Active Directory, mm-hmm. and AD, like we are creating on the server local server, which is at company location.
Mm-hmm.
So that is the different.
Right. So how like the any comparison you want to? Any other differences?
Yeah, differences there, like in we can able to use AD server on the company location only. Like I have to log in, so I have to be in the company VPN connection or over there, then I can able to access that. Azure Active Directory is an open source, which I can able to use from anywhere of the mm-hmm. outside mm-hmm. of the organization.
The major difference is, the second, read the second line.
Queried using the REST API over HTTP and HTTPS instead of LDAP.
What is LDAP?
It's
directory access domain protocol.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What is the port number?
Port number, I do not remember.
But your expectation is like I do remember those migration ports.
Yeah.
It's 389 actually.
389. Okay.
Yeah. And for RDP, it is 3389.
Okay.
You will never forget this because it's comparing LDAP and RDP. LDAP always 389 and RDP is 3389. So actually, your Azure Active Directory is not using LDAP as on-premise Active Directory is using LDAP and Kerberos. Mm-hmm. Remember? Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So that's the beauty of this modern authentication. If they start, you know, using LDAP and Kerberos, how they support this modern authentication? Right?
Yeah.
Read the third one. I think already I explained you, but it is a revision for you. Yeah.
Okay. Uses HTTP and HTTPS protocols such as SAML, WS Federation, and OpenID Connect for authentication and auth for authorization instead of Kerberos.
So the difference is?
The difference is like we are using for cloud
modern authentication.
Yeah, modern
authentication. All the modern authentication Azure Active Directory is supporting, but in on-premise, it's still using Kerberos.
The Kerberos, yeah.
Right.
Yeah. Right.
And the another one is like we have ADFS. Remember, Active Directory Federation Services.
Yeah.
ADFS.
Hmm.
So for single sign-on and multi-factor authentication. MFA, right? So that was kind of on-premise server-based solution. But here in Azure Active Directory, we are using as a service-based federation services. It's a service. We need not you know, install anything kind of thing, right? Hmm. And it can be used many third-party services. Just I give an example, Facebook and Insta. Remember?
Yeah.
Right. Just read the last line, actually. It's very important.
Azure AD users and groups are created in flat structure and there are no organizational unit or group policy objects.
That's eye catch.
Hmm.
You understood?
Yeah. User groups. So it is creating on a flat structure. Organization unit and group policy is not over there.
So you will not find OU or GPO into your Azure Active Directory, like on-premise Active Directory. That's a big difference. So no OU, no GPO. So you might be thinking how OU on-premise will be supported from Azure Active Directory on GPO, right?
Yeah.
So you have Microsoft Intune to support that, okay? So Microsoft will not spoil their business, actually. Don't worry about that. They're very smart. They're smarter than us, right? So they have some backup plan, actually, because a lot of competition going on in identity services. Mm. And Microsoft want to be in big competitor in the market, right? Like Okta solution. is a big competitor for Microsoft. So they do want to be, you know, they want to be number one. So that's why they have backup plan for to manage OU and GPO. You can manage it through Microsoft Intune. I'm pretty sure you must be knowing the Intune.
The device should be registered on Intune. Yes. And everything. Yeah.
Daily we are using actually, right?
Yeah, right.
Any other differences apart from this? Your real-time thought, actually, you just can think of anything. What is not mentioned here?
So I think so. In Microsoft is preparing Intune as a OS as well on that.
Yeah, on the Windows 10. Yeah, right. Yeah. Very right. Yeah. And they also launched a new operating system, Windows 11 also, beta version. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Any other thing? Differences between ADDS and Azure Directory? Forest is not there.
Okay.
Same like, you know?
Yeah, so it will be like if units and group policy is not there, so it will be automatically deleted.
Yeah. So forest is not there. Domain control concept is not there. So a lot of changes actually, right?
Right.
Yes, but
I think it is a completely new thing.
Yeah, right. So this is kind of, if you remember, I told you P1 and P2.
Yeah, P1 and okay. P2, premium one and
premium two, right? So all this Microsoft 365, O365 is not required for us. It's a different, you know, Microsoft O365 family actually, where you talk about Exchange Online, you know, your SharePoint Online, MS Teams, OneDrive for Business, and all those things. Those things are not part of our, AZ-104. And that's a different line, actually. You know, mail solution, Exchange solution, actually. Okay?
Okay.
But you have to focus P1 and P2. What is not in P2? What is not in P1? That's important. See.
Identity protection. Identity governance.
Means two security features are not available in P1. And that's why they are charging. And the P1, P2 licenses is also like double. If they charge $1 per user in P1, in P2, they will charge $2 actually. Okay. But security is a major concern nowadays, right?
Yeah.
And why I'm talking too much security? Because I'm also into cloud security, right? So that's why you will see everywhere I will be talking in reference to security. Okay. Don't get bored. Yeah. Take it positive.
No.
Future is for security only.
Yeah, okay? Yeah. Future is for security.
So, okay. Suppose you have to join your machine in your on-premise into domain. How will you join that?
So, for that, like you told, LDAP ports should be open over there. And your machine, like you once you join in your domain, it should be also joined to Azure AD domain joined.
Right. So actually, Azure AD for Azure AD join, you have to install the Azure AD directory services, domain services actually, within the Azure portal. I will show you. That is a part of our lab actually. Okay. We will be doing the lab and how we can join our domain, you know, our VM into the Azure AD domain. That will do in our lab activity. Okay? So the benefit will be kind of, you know, all those things you are going to do. Each VMs, one VM can communicate to another VM. All those things possible through Azure AD join. This functionality is required for the Windows servers and Windows 10, right? You heard about VDI things?
Yeah.
So what is the benefit of VDI?
VDI is like they are using a Citrix application to log in it, and they can able to log in from anywhere, from any system. So they do not require any, only system should be there to enter the URL, and they can, and it is a like on VM, they have to do the changes. Like on one virtual server, they have done the change, and it will be applicable on the all VMs automatically.
Right. Okay. So do I have to explain SSPR? I don't think so.
No.
Not required, right? It's your baby. Yeah. Okay. And finally, you are going to check everything as, you know,
knowledge check.
Right. This is not very important. And so, like, any questions?
So, question is...
and like your question should be what we are discussing, actually. It's not next level, no? Next topic question. Keep in mind.
Yeah.
So, migration things, we are parking, because it's a separate topic we are going to discuss, where we are going to discuss everything. Don't worry about that.
Mm.
Yeah. So, any pre-question or related with those discussion, actually, that will make sense. Yeah, please go ahead.
Yeah, so like we are like, there's not OU and trees are not over there, so we are creating an account on Azure. So the syncing part with the on premises, like how it will be managed.
Yeah, again, it's a question, next question actually yours. I will come to that. Azure AD Connect, yeah. So how we can connect on-premise to those, okay?
Yeah.
Hold on your horses. So you're going to get answer of automatically these questions. Try to ask questions what is relevant to this discussion. If not, we can move forward.
Okay.
Yeah, okay. So this Azure AD Connect will come into the picture later on, okay? How we can do that and how our on-premise Active Directory will communicate. All those things we are going to discuss, and we'll do also demo kind of thing, okay?
Okay.
So user account, group account, multiple directories, you know. So these are very simple things, and we can do into lab for now without, you know, doing all those things into the presentation. Let's go and do the lab part, actually. Okay. Okay. Can you log in into your portal quickly?
Azure account,
which I... Yes, sir. Okay. And share a screen, because PPT might be boring, actually, because you will find lab thing very interesting.
For lab part, I have to actually switch to another system because this is a SQL machine and Gmail is not allowed over. Let me check, maybe cloud.
And portal will be allowed, actually. Yeah, don't worry.
Yeah.
Gmail you manage from your mobile, okay? And portal you log in from SQL also, it will be allowed for sure. No restriction.
So my screen is visible to you or not?
I think you have to share, right? You already share?
Once visible, let me know.
Yeah, it's visible now. Yeah, you can see. So go to Azure portal. Yeah, no, not this one. Type Azure portal. Yeah, type there Azure portal. No. Just Google it, Azure portal, yeah. Okay. Why to remember the website name, right? Azure portal, yeah. Google is going to help you. Take help from Alexa, right? Yeah. Yeah, this is the portal.azure.com. Yeah, correct. Maybe later. And give me remote control, actually. I will ask and you can approve it, okay? Request control. Yeah, you have to approve it. Approved?
Yeah, I have approved.
Okay, sir. So if you go here, left side, you will see everything here, right?
Yeah.
And this is our baby. For discussion.
Azure Active Directory.
Yes. So you see here, whenever you registered, you know, as a free tree account, a free subscription, it is showing you default directory. Okay. So this is your default directory on which we are working. And you can call it as tenant also. This is tenant, right? Okay. And what is the tenant ID? Yeah. Same like if you remember any Active Directory, SSID, all those things,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, SSID.
Yeah. And this is your primary domain. On Microsoft.com, right? And the license, Azure AD Free. Remember when we were discussing the spreadsheet, there were four types. I ignored actually. We focus on P1 and P2. This is another one type of license. Generally, we use as a free tier, right? For lab purposes. So come now. Your Azure AD Connect is showing. We discuss later. And what else we can discuss here? See, this thing we are going to play around. Azure AD Domain Services. We have to install it. Okay.
Okay.
To make use of Azure AD, domain joining. We have to install that. We have to configure that. I will share the documentation with you later on, and you can play around. So if you go to users, so see, all those things are there, right? Users. Yeah. So you go and add more users by your own. Yeah, go add in few users like you add me, you add some dummy user kind of. Yeah. No caps, I think.
Okay.
R is small, yeah. I think that might be easy. Space instruction. Yeah. Okay. Dutmesh. Yeah. Copy paste. Andy, PNDY. Come down and is a location India. I think those things you might be doing, in your
previously I have done, but not in Azure form. Okay. Previously, like in local servers, once we creating an account over there,
you can mention trainer, MCT trainer, trainer. Training, XYZ, anything, no manager selected,
create.
So try to create another user also, new user, dummy user. Right. India. Things are very simple, actually. Very Azure administrator friendly, employee friendly, user friendly. Everything is awesome here. Just save it. No, save it. Okay. Now go to groups. Go back.
New.
No. Okay. Add one guest user also. Guest user. Yeah. So what will be the guest user? Select first one. Go up. Second one. Invite user. Yeah. This is the guest user actually. Who is not part of your company actually? As a vendor, third party, you can also guest user. Yeah.
So I have to give the email address also.
You have to provide, yes, you provide your email address only, right? This is a test one. Later on we'll delete it, don't worry.
So anything I have to write or it should be valid
one, else how will add it? You have to provide your own, your only. Just for testing only, nothing else.
Okay.
Later on, we can delete it. Yeah. XYZ, type ABCD, something. Just click on any user. Just see what are the properties you are seeing here. Click on the user. Yeah. Just click on that. Yeah. Double click.
I have to right click or what?
Double click. It's not the line. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So see what are the properties you are seeing here, right? So it is showing right. Password reset option is showing here. And you are getting your UPN number, right? UPN name, actually, right?
Unique.
This one, your object ID, right? And everything showing settings. We'll go down. So, okay.
Contact info is not authentication.
User. So, like, go to authentication methods. Click on authenticate methods, yeah. Okay. So, actually, if you want to enable MFA, remember? Multi-factor authentication. So that also you can configure for the users. That's a part of, you know, MFA. Okay, now go to, go back. And you want to see the licenses, click on license, left licenses, yeah. So, because we are using free tier, so we need not to worry about this, right? Go to groups now, create one group by adding these users actually. Add members. Then it will ask you give the name of the group, right? Search. You have to search Anu, yeah. Ratnesh, likewise. Anu is not coming. Ratnesh? No. This is group you are selecting. No group is there, sir. This is our first group, right?
So we have to we are getting an option to create.
Just cancel it. Yeah. And go to home again. Home. Yeah, Azure Active Directory, the first one. Yeah. Click on groups. Yeah.
New group.
Yeah. So just go to group type. Group type. Yeah. Select. So here you can see there are two. What is the difference between these two?
So one is a security group and second is a Office 365. The security group
go ahead. Yeah.
So security group is like we create any security authentic for DL purposes, security authentication.
So there was distribution secure universal security groups, all those things. The same like security group, right? You're creating AD security group actually, right?
Mm-hmm.
And Microsoft 365 is like will be used for your
offices
Microsoft
and
O 365 family, Exchange Online, SharePoint Online, MS Teams. Mm-hmm. So what are the difference between these two?
So it is for office purpose and it is for the security, like users should be added in that security group.
Right. So actually in O365, M365 only possible is like users only. But in your security group, you can play with other objects also, right? Isn't it?
Yeah.
Like your computer name, manager identity, all those things. Okay. Okay. Come down. Name it. And anything, Sam's test or something. Anything. Yeah, I mean, you can assign ownership. Oh, no, wait. Here only, just no owner selected. Click here, make yourself owner. Yeah, and now select members here. Yeah, here only. Yeah, no member selected. Yeah. Select everyone, not everyone actually, select by Search Ratnesh. Go to search. I think Ratnesh was also there, huh? Selected. And one guest user also there. Okay. And yeah. Yes. And some guest, yeah. Okay. Any other users there? It's okay. Oh, two members we have now. Okay.
Only three members.
Yeah, great. Yeah, so
does
go, yeah, go into double, the, yeah, double click, yeah. Just read the membership type, you know. So it is showing assigned, okay, source, cloud, type this, like this. So same like in Active Directory, you must have seen, you know, creation days, what is object ID. So it's kind of similar, but yes, it's completely on cloud, right?
Yeah, right.
And how it is communicating between the Azure cloud and everything, right? So how you can play around with your users, your groups, you know, and all those things, you can do it here. Okay.
Okay.
So after creation in this, stop sharing.
Sorry?
Stop your sharing, please.
Okay.
Yeah. So we like, so this is good. I like, we got the portal access actually, right? So yeah, this is really good. So coming to those things you have to explore actually, okay, by your own. Go and check all those things and easily you can do that. Okay.
Okay.
This is very basic. So I think lab is there. And this is kind of homework, like assignment for you, actually. No, I will not say like homework because it looks like we are into, you know, school, college kind of.
Yeah.
So take it as like assignment, actually, okay, or lab. Yeah. So you have to complete this, you know, this.
Okay.
Yeah, you can do this. I think we already did it, but do more, actually. Okay. And try to, you know, understand this thing. If you have any question, we'll discuss. Try this lab. Okay. This simple lab.
Okay. So like I have created the user, if I want to log in somewhere, so it can be, it will be work or not?
Where you want to log in that user?
Like I log in on my personal system or somewhere.
No. How it will work, man? Come on.
Like if I want to, for a testing purpose, I want to join my personal system domain and that, and it will be there.
No, for a lab. It will not. Yeah, it will not. Yeah. So just play around with this one. Okay. And okay. We'll move forward and we'll doing the, you know, complete. I think the major thing will be like, you know, how we can ADDS we can install, configure it. Okay. And how, okay, Azure domain joining, we can do that. We will be also creating one virtual machine also, you know,
okay,
Windows 10 or something. So there we can play around. And also like custom domain thing we are going to discuss, you know. So I'm going to share the slide with you. Okay. And you play around with all your, you know, Azure subscription until what you can play by yourself.
So which thing I do not have to use, so that like it is a amount is will be get deducted as you told.
So yeah, so actually the smarter, because see, this is a free tier actually, right? And we have to be very smart because we are not paying anything actually, right?
Yeah.
So right. Smartest will be like try to, you know, if you are making any, suppose you created any VM, so don't keep it on always, put it shut down. That's just one smarter way. Don't keep your resources power on actually, because it is going to charge you every day. So cloud is charging every second, actually, every minute, every hour. So two US dollars is not too much. It's very less amount. So it will be exhausted very soon, because we need this 200 until this end of this month, July 31st, at least, you know, for our practice sessions, for our discussion, for our demos, actually, right? For our lab purposes. So I will advise, whatever you're doing, try to shut down it. And if shutdown is not working for it, delete it, create it once again. not a problem. It's our practice, right? We'll do more practice. We'll be more hands-on. Okay?
Yeah, of course.
And also, finally, our target is to clear the interviews.
Yeah.
Okay? So that will come. That will part will discuss after completing maximum things, actually, in the later stage. Last week, actually, the interview part. What interview? You know, I'm also into the panel in our my current company. You know,
okay.
So okay. We know how the interviews happened and what question even in panel also asked, actually, and capability in Azure Cloud is not too much. You don't think like you are into a crowdsourcing kind of very less. Mm-hmm. You know. Is still knowledgeable people in the cloud, you know. So people are working in the on-premise and they are reading YouTube and coming for the interviews. So the problem is they don't have some hands-on experience or real-time scenarios, and that's a problem where interviewer panel is going to catch you. You don't have any experience in Azure. You are coming from the on-premise environment and you are just applying for Azure Cloud. So that mm-hmm. gap we have to fill it here. In our sessions, and our target will be to get new job, update your resume, you know, after mm-hmm. 1 month or 1.5 months, something like that, and mm-hmm. get ready for the interview.